It has been notified. The announcement is there. It is going to be launched or made effective from 1st of July 2023. Some of the important aspects, the dates have already been announced of this scheme. So as far as the examinations are concerned, in the month of February, the ICI had made the announcement that in November 2023 attempt of intermediate and final examination would be under the existing scheme. मतलब जो था the 30th June का जो scheme है उसमें and recently the announcement was made for foundation also that the December 23 exams of foundation would be done under the existing scheme. And so the new scheme, the new syllabus, the new pattern of exam, mind the new pattern of exam is because at the intermediate and the final levels, जहाँ पे चार चार पेपर थे, so we had 8 papers at intermediate, 8 papers at the final level, 2 groups of 4 each, which would now be 6 papers each. So you have 3 papers of 2 groups at the intermediate level and at the final level. So this new scheme would be made applicable from the May 2024 examinations for the intermediate and final, and June 2024 for the foundation examination. Right? So I think that is there in the announcement and we are all clear about that. On the practical training, those who are undergoing 3 years of practical training and till 30th June, students can register under 3 years of the practical training. They would continue under the 3 years of practical training. Right? So for them, the exam eligibility would also remain the same. That is, उनके जो final exams है, they would fall due in the last 6 months of their practical training. From 1st July, the new scheme comes into force, and therefore for practical training, वो date भी वहाँ पे लिखी है. From 1st July, the new scheme of 2 years of practical training would be implemented. The 2 years of practical training, what it has is that you have to clear both the groups of intermediate, then you join your practical training. 2 years of uninterrupted practical training, which means that you will not have any CA exam during these 2 years. 2 saal complete hone ke baad, there is a 6 month of study period after which you will be eligible to appear for your final examination. Right? Your eligibility for articleship, abhi jaise hai, your OC and ITT you have to complete before you join your articleship, your practical training. And for the 2 years training wale jo hai, for them, the MCS and the advanced ITT has to be done after completing 2 years of their articleship. So these 2 years is uninterrupted practical training. Articleship. The reason I have explained at a lot of places, but maybe this is my first opportunity, is that in 3 years, I forgot to mention that in 2 years of practical training, the eligible leave is 12 days per year, which means 24 days of leave. Because there will be no CA examinations in between, and therefore 24 days of leave is what is eligible. Because when you are undergoing, or when you are undergoing 3 years of articleship, if you consider the leave that is taken, 156 days of leave that is there for your final examinations, and what has been observed was that the students were not able to get the consistent training, because important compliance period or a very important work period, so the student, because of their examinations, were on leave, and therefore there always, or in many cases, there used to be a gap in their practical training, and hence this whole thought process of 2 years of practical training. So these are some of the important changes. The syllabus, as again it has been mentioned in the notification, the syllabus, the transition. Transition, matlab, I'll tell you, let's say somebody would have a question that intermediate, I've cleared first group of 4 papers. November, you will be appearing for second group. We
would be of 4 papers because we are having those exams under the existing scheme of education and training. If the student is unsuccessful, then May 24, mein, how would that 4 papers be converted? Right? So all these things, we will be coming out with these announcements on 1st of July once the scheme is launched. The syllabus also, the transition also, and there are no parallel exams. Matlab May 24 se nahe exams start honge. And again, I'll tell you the logic that, or I would ask you that how many of you would want to appear for 8 papers when you have the option to appear for 6 papers? Anybody? Kisi ko 8 paper dena hai kya? So many times, you know, these questions come, and we feel it our duty to explain why no parallel exam, because we feel that this new curriculum is going to be more beneficial for the students going forward, and that is why there will be no parallel exams under the new scheme May 24 onwards. So these are some of the aspects which I wanted to share with you. Like I said, you would have questions, I appreciate. Please wait, 1st July will be coming out with the requisite announcements, the transition scheme, and everybody will automatically or compulsorily have to convert into the new scheme because there will be no parallel examinations like I mentioned earlier. In case you have any further questions, you can always write to us, you can contact us, but I would presently, you can share with us, I would not have any difficulty on that. But just wait for the 1st July announcements where we are coming out with all the transition, conversion, the exemption provisions. Yes, one more thing on the exemption, which is there in the notification, and therefore I can share. Abhi aapko jo bhi paper mein exemption milta hai, you know the eligibility of exemption, I did not mention that. That you are allowed for 3 attempts. Exemption carry forward karna. And usme for the remaining paper, means overall group ka individual paper aapka 40% and overall group ka 50% aana chahiye, including that paper which is the exempted marks. And 3 attempt mein agar nahi hota hai, then your exemption is lost. That is what is the present provision. In the notification, what has now been said is, at the option of the student, you can carry the exemption beyond 3 attempts. But the condition is that in the remaining papers, you have to score 50% marks. But you can carry forward the exemption beyond your 3 attempts. Again, this is at the option of the student, whether the student wants to carry forward or not. So, I believe these are some important aspects. One more is the self-paced online modules. So, 8 में से 6 पेपर हुए इंटरमीडिएट में, 8 में से 6 पेपर हुए फाइनल में. इट इज नॉट के 4 पेपर कम हो गए, इफ यू वेरी ऑनेस्ट ऑन दैट. अगर आप टोटल देखेंगे दी होल करिकुलम, वी हैव 20 पेपर्स, 4 एट फाउंडेशन, 8 एट इंटरमीडिएट, 8 एट फाइनल, व्हिच इज द 20 पेपर्स. इन द न्यू स्कीम एन एडिशनल लेवल हैज बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड, व्हिच इज द सेल्फ पेस्ड ऑनलाइन मॉड्यूल्स. सो यू हैव द फाउंडेशन 4 पेपर्स, यू हैव द इंटरमीडिएट 6 पेपर्स. Then you have the self-paced online modules, 4 papers, and then you have final 6 papers. So as the name suggests, the self-paced online modules, these are all virtual tech-driven education learning which we are bringing at the ICI for the students. There are 4 papers, 2 hai, usme set A, set B, which are compulsory. The set A is on the economic and corporate laws. The set B is on the costing and the decision making. These are compulsory. Set C is an elective paper which is about specialization. So where you have subjects like IBC, forensic, sustainability, forex and treasury management, capital market, aise 10 subjects hai. Jisme se aapko koi bhi ek select karke pass karna hai. So this would just expose you to some area of your choice or specialization that you would like to do. And the 4th set is on multidisciplinary, considering the NEP 2020, where we have subjects like the Constitution of India and the Art of Advocacy. Another paper is on philosophy and psychology. The 3rd is the startup and entrepreneurship related, and the 4th is on the digital ecosystem. So these are the 4 papers. Usme se ek aapko select karna hai aur pass karna hai. And you will be eligible, for those who will be registering under the new scheme, you will be eligible for appear for your final exams only after you have cleared these 4 papers. But these 4 papers
मई नवंबर एग्जाम की नहीं होगी, दे विल बी ऑल ऑन द ऑनलाइन मोड, डिजिटल मोड. तो स्टडी मटेरियल विल बी ऑनलाइन, द वीडियो लेक्चर्स विल बी ऑनलाइन व्हिच यू विल हैव टू कंपल्सरी गो थ्रू, एंड द एग्जाम्स विल आल्सो बी ऑन ऑनलाइन बेसिस. सो दिस इज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द सेल्फ-पेस्ड ऑनलाइन मॉड्यूल. एंड फॉर द ट्रांजिशन, लाइक आई सेड, those who have cleared one group of final, one group of inter, both groups of inter, and in the existing scheme, what would they be required to study going forward, all that we will be announcing in due course. So this was with respect to the CREDT, the new scheme of education and training. And if you look how at the council the deliberations and all have been going on, that this was something, because normally the syllabus is revamped every 10 years. That has been the history, but the last revamp was in 2017 and we are in 2023. So we wanted in 22, but we got the approval just recently, and so we are in 23 when we are launching this. And the need is that we collectively, everybody, not just about students or about members of the council members, but everybody, we have to keep pace with the changing requirements, the changing expectations of the industry and the stakeholders. And that is the reason why we believe that this syllabus, the new curriculum, is futuristic, and we would have definitely better and more, I would say, acceptable chartered accountants going forward. But my request is, please wait for ICI announcements. Do not fall prey to any other announcements or anything that is coming up on social media. We would be coming up as and when things are clear for your benefit, for your betterment. And with this, once again, I thank the ICASA and DIRC for giving me this opportunity, for inviting me to my city, Kolkata. And I wish you all a very, very happy 2 days of learning, the study you've done today, and also wish you all a very, very happy career ahead. Thank you very much.